Yo, what's up? We are now at the regular spot. This is called Extra Neskollen. And I'm juicing up at the Grön Kontakt fast charger. This is the 150 kilowatt fast charger. So you guys know the drill. We are going to do an acceleration test. Yeah. This one is a BMW i3. It's the 120 amp hour, or I like to call it the 42 kilowattstunden then. So if you guys remember last year I tested the i3, but that was it was also 42 kilowatt hour, but it was i3s. This is the regular i3, and it's from iMove. Yeah, lots of i's here. But okay, so you guys can take a look a bit exterior wise. So I guess what is kind of important on this test are the tires. So let's see, might have to light up some here. So Viking Continental Viking Contact 7, and the dimensions are, this is winter tire here, 155 17 19, and let me just check that the front are the same. Viking Contact, of course, 7, but let me check here, 155 70 19. Yeah, so same for front and rear. Did I say 17? I meant 70, of course. Yeah, so front rear tires same. This is rear wheel drive, and we are juicing up now, and I'm gonna show you something nice here I found out since last time I tried this car. Look here, under here, there. Oh yeah, that is the OBD LX2, it's called. It works only for Android phones, I guess, but anyway, so the OBD port is there. And then tip for my viewers, you use an app called Electrified. It is Frei. I mean, actually, it's kostenlos. Yeah, kostenlos for the win. I mean, it's free. It's called Electrified. And all you have to do is just connect. Well, I mean, I already paired these two devices. I use the same, this is the same phone and the same, I'm gonna show you here. I have Leaf Spy. I have scanned my Tesla car scanner. Leaf Spy is for Leaf and ENV200. Scan my Tesla is for Tesla. Kanse is for Renault Zoe. And then cars, Can Ioniq is for Ioniq. And car scanner is for the Korean cars, Kona, e-Niro, Ioniq, and, well, actually, yeah, I use Ioniq for that one, but okay. So we use this one, Electrified. And you see right now, we can see here, car, we have temperature outside and kilometers per hour. We have the wind there. Battery is the one most, this one doesn't say anything. It's for AC charging. So since we're not AC charging, then no, nothing to see. So very nice, 86% the charge. We see voltage, current right now. Ooh, look at that, wow, damn. Even at 87%, we are receiving 48 kilowatt. That's not too bad. And see, battery is at 20 degrees only, huh? How much cobalt did you put in this battery? and actually, it says this car is very new. So you see, it says actually the capacity is 129 amp hour, even by specifications, 120. So maybe it's like they say 120 because they suspect some initial degradation or something. I don't know what this one means. State of charge HV, doesn't that mean high voltage? So this is the one that is displayed here. I can show you in the display. If we switch there, 88.5, you see, it's that one, the big number. This one, I don't know what kind of state of charge it is. And we also see cell voltage, state of health is 100%, and then rate. So not too much information there. You can't, I mean, settings, not too much to configure. So it's this one, but it's good enough. So let me show you also the i3 has no sport mode. You see there's a mode button here, and if you press it, wait, okay, I can't do this now, but it only has comfort mode, and then the Eco and the Eco Pro Plus or whatever. Yeah, so we only have that mode. So now we will just wait a little bit. I think, how many percent do I want? I want at least 95%. Ah, okay, now it's not throttle, okay. Yeah, but 40 kilowatt at 90%, that is very good for a small battery like this. So let's charge a little bit more, and then we do the launches. Launch number one. Launch number two. Launch number three. Launch number four. We're back home now, and let's check the result in the Google Sheet. So let's see now. Let's check the noise first. So this is summer. I split them in summer and winter. I guess you can just take a copy of these spreadsheet and customize it the way you like it. But at least for winter, I found it here. So now let's highlight this one and this one. You see the Oh shit! My bad. Okay, maybe I should learn how to use Google Sheet before I do this. There we go. Okay. So you see, the Nokian, for some reason, the i3s is noisier than the i3. I don't know why, because they have the same tire dimension, you see. The only difference is that we have Nokian Hakkapeliitta i3 versus Continental. And you know, I talk about this for the longest time, that the Nokians, they have this distinct howling noise that the Continental don't have. So many times when I measured Continental, they are more quiet than Nokian tires. This is yet another claim. I wouldn't say it proof, but you see that, okay, it's a little difference there versus here. Actually, it's just marginal difference, except for at higher speed, but okay. But you will see that the i3 is very quiet compared to many other cars. It's actually more quiet than Leaf. And what else? You can almost match i-Pace. Well, can it? Well, the Nieres are very quiet, but well, it depends. Depends how you look at it. But overall, though, you see it's in the upper half in the noise level here. And then when it comes to acceleration, then it doesn't come in the upper half, more like the lower half. Where is it? Further down. Here it is. So it comes down there. Even a Leaf is faster now. So yeah, don't leave me behind. Now the Leaf has 214 horsepower. So, I mean, 170 horsepower back in 2016 when it came out. It was a lot there then, but nowadays everyone and the mother has more horsepower. All these other cars above here, actually, this one until here, all these cars that have over 200 horsepower. So I feel like the BMW is getting a little bit lagging behind. Maybe, okay, with the i3s you get faster. So the Mini Cooper has the i3s power. So it has 182 horsepower, but this one's supposed to, the i3s is supposed to have 184. But also, you probably saw it in the video that it goes slightly slow off the line, and I always compare with the MG, because the MG is one of the cars that goes fast off the line. And you see here, when you compare them side by side, you see that the MG is faster up until 80 kilometers per hour. Past 80 kilometers per hour, the MG is slower, but you see, I feel like it's a bit slow. But what about Leaf? Leaf also felt slow. The ID3 was actually quite fast off the line. Let's do a little comparison here. Maybe not the max, but this one, the fastest ID3. Look how fast the ID3 is off the line, and just goes and goes and goes. So yeah, and there are different numbers for i3s and i3. So i3 is only 7.3 0-100. So and this one, well, to my surprise, it wasn't that much faster than spec for some reason. But okay, so at least I measure it. You guys want me to measure it? I measure it for you. Yeah, so I think that's gonna be it for now. Yeah, hope you guys enjoy this video. As always, thank you for watching, and talk to you later.